I just want to see how this truck would do four-wheeling. Should be running a gas line through here. That's pretty good. I don't even have the axle interlocked. Navajo Reservation in Farmington, New Mexico. This is actually a Navajo product. A bit breezy out. I think we're just gonna pull alongside this big old bale of hay. You got it, brother. Looks like he can just undo those lines and let the wind undo it. Good. Yeah, that's not happening. Brother, soft stop, soft, heavy. There we go. Man, look at that wind. I was telling him, I was like, I'm so glad I'm getting loaded with some heavy, with a heavy load, because you don't want to be driving an empty trailer in this type of wind. This is where I would shut it down. You'd have to be careful, because even being stopped on the side of the road, you could get blown over. Kind of like cow tipping. Look at that weather. That, I love bad weather. Absolutely love it. Makes you feel alive. Brawley, California. The dude was saying, he goes, he said, we're hardly doing anything. The thing's still way down. So they were doing like two trucks, one truck. You know, the other day I had four trucks. I'm like, what was a good day? 23. Damn. I know China buys a lot of the hay. But usually that's the stuff we send to Wilmington, California. This is like no place for a road machine. But she's doing just fine. All the years in the snow has taught me how to drive to keep from being stuck. Same thing goes in the sand. On the road again. We gotta wait for this guy coming down the road. Cause I need that swing. Just a swing in. Damn, there's more people coming. I'm going for it. Slow down a bit. We're on the reservation. There's no hurry for anything. We'll scale out. This hay should put us at the, I'm going to say the 35,000 load mark. Tight fit with this tractor coming down. You guys don't gotta get over that much. Maybe. I mean, like, he can go off-road. Shouldn't really be going off-road. I'm not going too much further. We are a road machine. How you doing, sir? Freeway flyer. The first time I started going to the Navajo reservation, I wondered what they actually did. I never saw them. I couldn't figure out why they didn't do any farming or anything like that. That's in Arizona. But over here in New Mexico, they have a huge farming operation. Just a little south of Farmington, New Mexico. Maybe it'll rain and we can clean off the windshield a bit. Because there's nowhere around here I can clean my windshield. When I say a truck, friendly spot, I basically mean a truck that has a 5-foot, 6-foot squeegee so you can clean instead of popping the hood and getting up there with one of them little 18 inch window washers and cleaners. Often wondered, I wonder how that Rain X would do, because it does good for rain, but I wonder how it would do if you put it on there and then bugs. You could just wash the bugs with the washer fluid and they'd come right off. I don't know, I'm gonna have to look into that and see. We are coming into a dust storm. find out what our weight is going to be. I know it's going to be wind friendly. You had me go to this scale instead of the other one. Maybe he's going to take a break over here, or he's based out of here. We're going to have to go back to the other spot. Stop. Sort of a weak one at that. If I would get a ticket right now for doing that, I would give up. But I said, serious, dude, you're kidding me, right? Jaywalking? Nice this morning. And then before he started loading, it started getting a bit breezy, and I was like, I'm glad I'm getting a load. Then it just, boom, it kicked up big time. Navajo pride. Get her on the scale. We are going to axle weigh. Looks like 80 pounds, though there's zero. So the wind's doing it a little bit. First wheel. I'm going to say 12,460. That's a good number. 45. I'm just going to say 45. It's close enough. That's 77.5. 480. Oh, it's going up, huh?
77,600.
The wind's probably jacking it up a lot. I'll say 77,540. All right. Yeah, it's kicked up big time, huh? Yeah. Has it been like this a few days in the past, or?
Yesterday was pretty good.
Yesterday's nice,
it's
huh?
It's really picking up now.
Yeah, because I came from Albuquerque empty. So that was nice. I didn't have to deal with this.
12460, 44940. And you got your gross rate on it.
Awesome.
It's not jumping around. 77, 400, 500, I don't know.
Yeah, I rounded off to 77.5.
Okay.
As long as we're not, 81 something or 80 something, we're good.
Okay, we'll see you then.
All right, see you next time, bro. Woohoo! Oh, I got my brakes set. Take a fuel. With a full tank of fuel, we're just right at 35,000 empty with a dry van. So that's when it gets scary. If you have a 45,000 pound load, you're like, bing, right on the money. Let's go to that other spot. Yeah, it would have been a pain in the ass to bring that empty from Albuquerque to here in this stuff. More likely, I would have shut it down, I think. Never done that yet, actually, shut it down because of the wind. But I think I would. Coming out of the other scales here. This place over here, they sell pinto beans, flour, popcorn, potatoes inside the building there. Like pinto beans are $1 a pound, but you can get a 20 pound bag for $15. They have all different sizes. Pretty nice spot. It's off of Highway 371, south of Farmington, New Mexico. Like I say, this is all their farming district. And all the stuff they sell in there is organic. Storm over there. At 77.5, we can handle it. But we couldn't handle a tornado. Get our windshield. windshield nice and clean. I could dig it. So we're off to Brawley, California. Should be over there, should get there tonight. Coming on the Navajo 5 road. The funny thing is there's a sign. Looks like they might have taken it down. It said no trucks. I talked to that dude, Lord of the Hay, which I've been there before. It's not the first time for our hay. He said he always sees trucks on this highway. So I've been taking it ever since. Well, anyway, if you're wondering why my windshield wiper blades are so slow, I'm having an issue with them. I'll show you, watch. I was talking to another driver. There, you see that? Stop. He's gonna have his motor replaced. Me this the other day, I'm like, every time you get a new truck, you have issues with it. It's like, I know. My wiper blades have been working. They would stop, and then they just all of a sudden quit. I turn the power off, turn the battery disconnect, and set for a little bit like that, and then they started up working again.
If
you want to come around to the blue truck. Alright, I'll let
you go when I get out. Get right now. Who's that white car, guys? You can play around me. Can't beat new wiper blades.
you have to watch this road. It can get pretty nasty. You'd be zipping along, and all of a sudden the road turns to crap. Like right now. Out there. Tractor, but he's really heavy. So are we, but I think I'm governed a little higher than he is. See what I mean? And the road just turns to crap all of a sudden. Eastern part of the Navajo Reservation. Funnel cloud to come down one of them clouds right in front of us. Arrowhead with the number N5 on it, Navajo. bouncy road. Day out there today also, it was 50 degrees. About 70 degrees over there where we got loaded up. Catch this next highway and go south to Gallup, New Mexico, then take 40 west up to Flagstaff, and then south. Get over there by Mexicali. Mexico. It's a merger of Mexico and California, Calexico. River runs through it. Snow on them still, it looks like. their roads are numbered 4-digit. The one we just passed was 8797. The one we were on, we were picking this up, was 7010. Okay if I say it, because I'm from Mexico. I'm not from Mexico, but my stepfather was Mexican. Drag me away. Actually, I bet they could. So we'll take this next highway south to Gallup. We'll do it in a full run. Not a gallop. Pedal to the metal. To New Mexico was 371, and this is 491 south. Put the flashers on. This guy's flying up, he's staying in our lane. 61 miles to Gallup. Arizona. This wind is pretty tough. Mexico. We want to go west to Flagstaff, Arizona. People up there in California, you see the fuel price over there, $2.69 a gallon. What is California, $4 a gallon? Really feel bad. You voted for him. Kept him in office. Almost doesn't seem possible we can make that turn right there. It's a piece of cake. I-40 is a major truck artery. We're going to split this dip. That wind is pushing pretty good. temperature's still 50 degrees outside.
A gas station, a convenience store, a gift shop, and a Route 66 themed restaurant. The visitor center complex is open 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. daily, with the Penny Desert Diner open from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. daily. The entrance station into the park is just beyond the visitor center complex. The fee is $20 for single vehicles and $10 for bicycles, motorcycles, and walkers. Various park passes are also available. Highlights as you travel through the 28-mile parkway include spectacular views of the Penny Desert, in the historic inn, Route 66, ancestral Scotland dwelling, one of the world's largest.
There is the information on AM radio 1610. You can tell it wasn't very good clarity for the petrified forest. Bridges close to Winslow, Arizona. here in Flagstaff. Looks like it snowed not too long ago. We were here the other day. It was not like this. So pretty much everybody got snow. We're southbound on a 15 or 17 right now. Degrees outside. Need to get some fluid in my reservoir. Usually see green grass and snow. On a 10 freeway in Arizona, a little place called Tonopah, AZ. Wasn't sure where I was, I had to look it up via the receipt. That mountain. Looks pretty damn cool if you ask me. Decent trip so far. Stopped and got some fuel there and cleaned off the suicidal insects. And we'll be getting hit more with them pretty soon. So I think we're about probably 3 hours away from our destination. And then it looks like we'll be going to Moreno Valley, pick up a Harbor Freight load and take it to Greeley, Colorado. So, until the next video, thanks for riding shotgun. Have a great rest of your day, and enjoy. Peace!